Melvin Gordon, the two-time Pro Bowler. He'll have it first down, past the 40. 41 yards there, a first down. Bit of a haymaker right after the starting goal, Charles. One play on the ground, and you're already on the other side of the 50.
I like how you went boxing there. Essentially went from the weigh-in to walking into the ring, being introduced, and firing away. Big shot early.
Whip. Watch the whip.
Tucker!
Here's Jones. Off play action. To Gordon, out left. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, he just snuck out there and he just got a nice first down.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. No gain on the play there. Second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Throwing Jones. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And they'll be inside the 25 now with the 24.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Ready.
Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get nine yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one.
54 is Mike. Check. Watch 54.
Yeah. Right there. 54. Right there. 54 Mike.
I'm coming.
Hey, zoom.
Go.
Now Jones. From the gun, he'll throw. Throwing the outlet incomplete. It's Gordon. Second Jew. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
54. So we got man.
Alpha.
54. Mike 54.
Are you ready?
Jones. Trading from the goal. Now it's Allen for the Charger touchdown. His third touchdown now on the air. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Flacco going to bring up the Broncos first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now the young man was a Pro Bowler as an undrafted rookie. It's Philip Lindsay. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Yep, you coming through the mark?
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
He's done it. He's done it. Three down.
You're over here.
Check.
On second down, a run with Lindsay. He's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Well, we talked about Philip Lindsay so much last year, but it bears repeating. Undrafted in 2018, the Broncos would sign him in May, and that was a good decision. He would have a 1,000-yard season, 9 touchdowns en route to a Pro Bowl appearance. So from undrafted to playing in the Pro Bowl in 10 months, that's pretty clean living for Philip Lindsay. Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Tim Patrick that time. That'll bring up second down. Here's Flacco off the play fake to Lindsey. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Melvin Ingram dropping the hammer off the edge.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Now after the sack, Flacco and the Broncos come up third and long. Third and long for Joe Flacco.
What?
Get this to his speedster, Paul Richardson. An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and then hold down their production, but I would just say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me previously. For a Bronco score, Philip Lindsay, his third touchdown now on the year. His guys are on the board here in this first quarter. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Extra point from McManus is good, and we are tied at seven. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
On the ready.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always up the score, but until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is, the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Now Gordon on first down. And out of the run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one good for 13 and a Charger first. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Hey! Hey, Rocket! Rocket! Boy! Boy!
You're all mine! You're all mine, baby! Get this! You're all mine! Go!
Now jump. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Back to throw. Jones. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Credit the sack to Von Miller.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say. When you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
These two teams all tied after one. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Cut.
Mike 54.
Leo. Hey, Sam off.
Watch twist.
Say, hey, Wahoo. You draw porkers.
54 is Mike.
Looking to throw. Jones. Pressure again, and down he goes again.
He killed Jones.
Whistles and a stop. A man down on the return.
Oh, my God.
We'll step aside and come back to Carson after this.
All right.
You're going to kill baby Jones? And he got
Nah.
This will be fielded at the 17.
My James is going. Yeah, now we, yeah, come on.
A good return there, come 17 on. Yards. And the Broncos take Let's over, go. First down, and
come
10.
Come on, Jones, stay in the game, son. You're a rook, son. You're too late. It's early, son. Go. Fight or flight, man. Get this shit together.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense.
Pick them up. Don't just let them. Pick them up and put them on his fucking neck.
Tackle made there by the safety.
Let that nigga on his motherfucking neck.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
It's going to be a little depth.
Yo, Lee.
Here's Falco. Flushed out right.
What?
Chunk of yardage before being dropped the, inside the 40. 23 yards to pick up there.
We're fucking hard, man.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Titans Ringo, Titans on Ringo, Titans on Ringo. Edward Gaffney.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey.
Oh my God. How y'all let that nigga push you like that, son?
Right side. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Philip Lindsey with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Broncos have taken the lead. McManus's point after is good, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula to get them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Second and one. The attempt on the dive, and he has it for a catch. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos 43.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball,
yeah,
you
hurt
must
Jones.
Have a lot of confidence, or you think you're really going to fake them out, and it looks like they did exactly that.
He's back.
Going deep in the playbook, and a great grab on the other end.
Hey, Orbit!
Jones now, on first down.
Oh, good defense.
Incomplete, too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield
right.
As it turned out.
Couldn't
even
find
his outlet, all man,
right.
Because of the coverage. It's way too Ron tight. Unable to find anyone nervous. Open.
Because his line.
So second down.
Oh, yeah, three plays.
To go ball on the 45.
His line.
So a jump defensively.
That's a killer.
Yeah,
watch
fun.
The football. Don't move past the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and 5.
Just never know.
Back to throw. Jones.
Hunter Henry.
This is going to be another first down. It's a big tackle at the Broncos 28. Well, last year, Henry really looked poised for a prime breakout season, but then May 22nd, tore his ACL during OTAs, ruled out for the year. actually was added to the active roster in a pretty heroic return for their playoff clash with New England, but did not play. 29 career games for Henry, 12 touchdowns, and now with Antonio Gates' career coming to a close, they expect a lot out of the 24-year-old Hunter Henry.
Oh! Yo, they got him. He got happy feet right now, son.
Let's see who this is on.
You gotta let that shit go. He's scared to death. This is almost broke his leg. What the fuck do you expect him to do? That nigga's scared. It's alright, man. Because next half, if we gotta pull out Phillip Dillup. Wow, dang. Boom, boom, boom. That's how he gonna come out. If we gotta bring him out, Grease. Might have to bring that nigga out tonight. You make my arms say.
They lose the yardage,
real
and of course,
quick.
They also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long.
That's how y'all fucking do it.
Hey, watch out.
Just
Mike,
on, Mike,
Mike.
All
right. I'm coming after you.
Ready? Here's Jones from the downhill throw.
Oh, bad pass.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off down at the 10.
He took too much away from the
center.
It has to. And I know he feels like the world is just tumbling down at this moment, but there's got to be some veteran somewhere, some mentor that's going to tell him, hang in there, my man. Plenty more to come.
Boy, you get
keep firing.
Out of control.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And the last two drives, both ending in touchdowns. It's got him this 14-7 lead.
And it looks to me, and I think you probably see the exact same thing.
I don't know. Stop that shit,
man. The way that they're functioning their offense now, they create a pretty good gap. Allows their defense to play with a little more verve and confidence.
This morning about them stringing possessions together for consecutive touchdowns. So right here, they're trying to make it three in a row.
Little play.
And Ron only got a yard. He's second and nine.
He's checking quick.
Flacco on the give to Lindsey.
Oh my! Yeah, thank you. Finally, put some spice on this motherfucker.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw.
Yes.
And the Chargers is going to get there.
That's why his ass going fast.
Credit the sack to Joey Bosa.
Hindsight is 20/20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Coming up at intermission. Charles, you want to wait and enhance your Saturday?
I certainly do.
Don't miss a thing for you. It's the coach.
I'm just I don't get fine. Great to go.
We'll be alongside and have to take us through the weekend in the NFL. Joey Bosa in on the stop. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Hey, exit.
Flacco, off play action. And it's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they head to the sideline to talk over what to do next. Here's Brian Anger now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from
man,
deep in his own end zone.
Yeah, that's good pick, man. Good pick, man. James said he wants a shot. Give him a shot.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go, it's been a tight game. You figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum. momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football.
Let's go now. 60 out, law.
Check, check. 154. 154. You get one. Yo, that's just a classic. No flex.
Now Jones. Throwing on first down.
Coming,
coming. Sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Mike by four.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. A pickup of 7 there, but they'll still have 12 yards to go on third down. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half.
Yeah, just in case shit get a little critical, aka, nah, that nigga still on the team, son. Oh, this nigga hot. Ah, back in the mail is gone. Damn. Oh my God. Oh.
And falls incomplete, almost being intercepted. A pick there.
Way you're playing it, man.
Now it's fourth down.
You played your ass. Damn. My man.
Now the second-year kicker, Michael Badgley. He hit from 59 as a rookie.
This
will approach NFL record territory. It's a 62-yard attempt. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
This got to be cream cheese. 62.
Now the second-year kicker, Michael Badgley. He hit from 59 as a rookie. This will
I don't know if I do it. I saw it. Come on. Come on. Oh, the game is bumped up. Who you with?
A sensational effort from that
distance. You with this nigga.
Rejected by the bar. The Chargers, a team that's really been plagued by poor field goal kicking the last decade or so, but I think they feel they've solved their problems with Badgley.
I would say so. He went 15 for 16 in 10 games last season, undrafted out of Miami. And remember, he had 5 field goals in the playoffs against the Baltimore Ravens.
Fuck that. Fuck that.
On first down.
Oh, this nigga think he slipped my dick. Triple. Since you think he motherfucking ill.
He's able to take it down to the 42. Now a timeout taken.
Motherfucking hell.
Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
That's a good play. I think that's a ball play too. I can't really remember. Yeah, great. That's the world, man.
Man, ready!
Watch the ship! Watch the chain!
Now the Notre Dame man, this is Theo Riddick. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, my motherfucker is good, man. Oh, yeah. We got to catch this one. This is a catch. Yep. Yeah, I'm out of here.
So on now say, is Brandon McManus. He has hit from as far away as 57.
Yeah, I'm at the
that was in Denver. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard
attempt. Oh, well, he's going to take the 800 out.
Oh, my God. No good. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports halftime report. Coach? Memphis fielding at the two.
Give me one.
And he'll take this. Somebody got to the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27 yard line. Offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
Oh, another turn back, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their play block. And like what they did in the first half, that worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try to hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Oh, no. Oh, is that old ass Sanders put that move on us like that?
A huge play there for Denver. 42 yards.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because
Shake, you like.
But he is so difficult to get down in the open field. They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10.
Now a carry. I'm just picking his little ass up. Herm.
We have not seen that much today. Different story this time around. We had a huge gain followed by a sizable loss here.
Protect this lead. Give it to the backs. Play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
25. They got that. Grenade.
Third down. Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Okay. Able to knock it through and give his guys three.
I like his poise. Good. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you'll see a lot of guys sag and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
That go together. That go together.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away.
In the town. I'll go out there tomorrow.
The end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, same shit. Yo, son. Huh? You.
Yeah. It's the Charger drive about to get going.
They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though.
Oh, shit.
Put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know what they had? They discussed how they were going to get
it done.
This is where scripting comes into play.
Filler, right? Yeah, you can't handle the funk, Broncos. All right.
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 for the 25. Now Rivers throw into the hands of Gordon. They'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, Rivers.
Oh, what a fucking hit, Chuck.
Together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively brings up fourth down.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Whoa. Ref.
Field ready to start their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field.
Oh, my fucking.
Good. I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly
oh,
right.
There he goes. Left side. Good play.
And all the way home to the Broncos score.
Lindsey.
78 yards. And the Broncos push further out in front. But he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who's a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big time play for a touchdown.
Oh. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Oh.
Hey, boy. That's back. That's back. Come on now. Yeah,
the offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
They've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't come before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked as well, and maybe try and find one of those special plays for one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
That throw into the arms of Allen, and they nearly get this all the way to midfield, marking down at the 49. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Rivers now to throw on first down. And he'll go right back to Allen. That's complete. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 20 yards on both of those plays back to back there. They are moving now. It's another first down. Rivers now. Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. He goes full extension, and he's got it. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Rivers now.
Oh, my. Good shit.
It's Chris Harris.
Chris Harris. That was
fucking there as his guys will get the football back. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it. And the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of the guy. And can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is getting enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Oh, my God. That was about to
let
him
take this one across the 30-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out in every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
They'll run. It's Lindsey. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Third and 11. And some extra depth in the secondary here. They're in the dime.
One.
From the gun. Flacco. Open man. It's Allen. Allen hit. He lost the football. So it goes as a
good
fumble.
Game,
but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
That that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. In this case, they were able to retain possession. But that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast on a big sack. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. A run with Lindsey out of the gun. He'll get 2 yards back, but it's going to leave him with a long third and 13.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third
rewind,
down.
Rewind.
Operating out of the gun, Flacco.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy can hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Will they make up for it? Now this throw caught left side. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. But defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
Right there, 54, Mike.
Let's go. Hey, I said
to throw Rivers. Henry's got him on the left side. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
Zero.
Rivers to throw it. They'll let this go for the end zone. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong and a deep ball, and now they face a third down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? The secondary really put this receiving core locked down.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
On third down, Rivers. It's complete, Henry. And they have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. How about 25 yards on third down? They'll take it.
Mike 54. Don't get nervous. Wait, 89.
They'll run on first down. Gorman. And that will be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
White. Wait.
Throwing on second and 8. Rivers. Throws left side, complete to Keenan Allen. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Easy.
4 yards on the completion. It sets up a third down. This is Melvin Gordon. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. And a field goal obviously means nothing here. They're going to go ahead and go for it on 4th down.
Now Rivers on 4th down.
Got a man, it's Allen for the Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen with his 2nd touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the lead down to 10, 24-14. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away.
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Now the Chargers will use the 2nd of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this 4th quarter.
That's a shit.
And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a 1st down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
The Charger drive about to get going. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Because the secondary, they really look good. They'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Philip Rivers, no stranger to 4th quarter comebacks. He's led the Chargers back to victory 26 times coming into this year. But work to do here if he wants to add another notch to the belt. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the 2-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Hey, Echo!
Set the tone, defense. Set the tone, defense. Let's go. Mike
35,
Mike
35. Throwing on 2nd and 1. Rivers. This throw is going to be incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and it's 3rd down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. The Chargers on 3rd down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. He's going to let it fly.
Oh,
incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's 4th down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
Red! Hey, Hey, box truck, box truck.
54 is Mike, 54 is Mike. Check, check, watch.
Rivers to 24 on fourth.
Oh,
that,
yeah.
And that should do it.
And then they don't let me get over the this game. Good job. Anyway, I can't. I game is over here. But I'm just saying. And then that guard and just get over that all. Just get mopped up by other people getting blocked. Like,
this is.
Get up there. He just got mopped in the whole crowd.
Like, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. What, you just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I've been for a guy once we were down huge. It's like I said, coach, would you on the call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here in 2 seconds on every time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, put this one behind them.
12.
Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever red zone? I wonder what the next
oh, my, what is the... Come here.
A lot of teams like these momentum to launch another one.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Rivers incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. Throwing again. Rivers. And this is complete. It's Allen. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. From 13 yards out. And the Chargers, they're able to cut into that deficit.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that.
Well, the Chargers are pointing, and they've got it. Well, that certainly makes things more interesting. You get the score, then you get the onside kick. A little uphill battle still, but a start.
It's not mission accomplished, but the plan is working. They're in a great spot right now, and the best part, they put the defense right back out on the field.
They just don't. Chris, fuck it. That's it. Just leave it alone.
It's been a game of punch.
All the fucking chips I done came across today, and I couldn't get one.
He's got the first down to go past midfield. A big game there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. You and I both know. Well conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
How about this? Flacco setting to throw it. And he will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very
every
gifted.
Time I'm undefeated, I just get one of the bullshit ass.
That does you no good.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him? Either fellow receivers or offensive linemen. That makes him play a really nice timing play.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Paul Richardson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Broncos push further out in front.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. McManus now for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. after the touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Defense
now at the line, ready for their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one's not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. You're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right out of the 40-yard line. Von Miller, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
Philip Rivers played one
half. So for Denver, they move back over 503-2 now on the year. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the home team here,
it was a good first month, but they'll fall to
4-1 as they suffer their first loss. And they will.
That's why I didn't give a fuck about playing Dave Jones. It was a game. Was it this game? My bad. Let me talk to this nigga in his DM. This is why I like to set my games, because I forgot I had something to fucking do this game. I was trying to get a fucking superstar, trying to get an upgrade done, and I wasn't even giving this nigga the ball. I worry about Danny Jones. Like, I fucking hate pop-up games, bro. That's why I tell niggas to schedule shit. I didn't talk about the loss. I wanted to get that shit more than anything. God damn. I'm bad, man. I don't even know if you're gonna fucking match for it again. Fuck, man. Damn, Mike. I forgot I was about to give this. Supposed to give this nigga the ball, son. I totally fucking forgot about that shit. Alright, I'm not fucking around with James Jones.
Now let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team.
Damn, Chris. Fucking forgot, man. That got me mad.